This is Jeffrey Drazen for the New England Journal of Medicine. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, commonly known as COPD, is characterized by progressive airflow obstruction, cough, sputum production, and dyspnea. Acute exacerbations leading to treatment with antibiotics, glucocorticoids, or hospitalization are common. Up to 40% of patients with COPD have an eosinophilic phenotype, with blood eosinophil counts of 2% or more. These patients have an increased risk of COPD exacerbations compared to patients without blood eosinophils. Could such patients benefit from decreasing eosinophils by treatment with mepolizumab, a monoclonal antibody that blocks interleukin-5? Two randomized placebo-controlled double-blind multinational studies in patients with COPD addressed this question by examining exacerbation rates when patients were treated with maximum inhaled therapy plus mepolizumab or placebo every 4 weeks for 12 months. The METREX study recruited COPD patients without respect to blood eosinophils, while the METRIO study included only patients with high eosinophil counts. In METREX, in the pre-specified high eosinophil population, the annual rate of moderate or severe exacerbations was 1.40 per year with mepolizumab versus 1.71 per year with placebo. When patients were included in the analysis without regard to eosinophil counts, there was no difference between groups in the COPD exacerbation rate. In METRIO, mepolizumab had no significant effect on the annual rate of exacerbations. In a pre-specified analysis, there was a trend toward greater treatment effect in patients with higher blood eosinophil counts. The key insight from the study is that eosinophils appear to have a causal role in COPD exacerbations. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.